स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी द फोर्थ चैप्टर ऑफ फिजिक्स फ्लूइड्स। फॉलोइंग टॉपिक्स वी विल स्टडी टुडे: फर्स्ट बुयांसी, सेकेंड अप थ्रस्ट, थर्ड यूनिट ऑफ अप थ्रस्ट, फोर्थ इफेक्ट ऑफ अप थ्रस्ट, एंड नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज फैक्टर ऑन विच अप थ्रस्ट डिपेंड्स, एंड नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ अप थ्रस्ट। लेट अस स्टार्ट विद बुयांसी। When we immerse anybody in a liquid, then it experience an upward force. That force is called upthrust, and the characteristics by which it experience an upward force, that characteristics is called buoyancy. Upthrust is also called buoyant force. What is the unit of upthrust? Since upthrust is a force, so the unit of upthrust is also Newton. So the unit of upthrust is Newton. It is denoted by N. What is the effect of upthrust? When we immerse anybody in a liquid, then it loses its weight. Means its weight is lesser than the actual weight. So this is the effect of upthrust. What is the factor on which upthrust depends? First, the size or volume of the body immersed in a liquid. Means when we immerse more volume of the body in a liquid, then it experience more upthrust. When a body completely immersed in a liquid, then it experience maximum upthrust. Second factor on which upthrust depends: density of liquid in which the body is immersed. If we immerse same object in two different liquid, both liquid have different density, then the upthrust exert on a body is less which have lesser density. Next, we study the characteristics of upthrust. Now we will study the next topics: characteristics of upthrust. What is the characteristics of upthrust? The upthrust exerted by fluids on an object is directly proportional to the volume of immersed part of the object. Second characteristic is, the upthrust exerted by a fluid on an object is directly proportional to the density of the fluid. And third characteristic is, the upthrust is independent of the nature of the immersed object. Next characteristic is, the upthrust acts on immersed object is in vertically upward directions at the center of buoyancy. Means if the volume of the immersed part be increased, then upthrust is also increased. If the density of the liquid be increased, then upthrust is also increased. If we immerse two different objects of the same volume in a liquid, then both objects experience same upthrust because both objects displace same amount of water. So both objects experience same upthrust. So upthrust is independent of the nature of the immersed objects. So these are the characteristics of upthrust. Start with the next topic: Archimedes principle. What is Archimedes principle? When a body is partially or completely immersed in a liquid, then it experiences an upward force, that is upthrust, which is equal to the weight of the liquid displaced by a body. Means when a body is partially or completely immersed in a fluid, then it experiences an upthrust. That upthrust is equal to the weight of the fluid displaced by the body. How can we prove this Archimedes principle? Let us consider a cylindrical body of cross sectional area A submerged in a liquid of density rho. Let the upper face of the body is at the depth h1. This is the body, and the depth of upper surface is h1. and the depth of the lower surface is h2 and the height of the object is h2 minus h1, that is h. Now let us consider the pressure exerted on the upper surface, that is p1, is equal to h1 rho g. Since the height is h1 and since the height on upper surface is h1 and density of liquid is rho, so the pressure exerted on upper surface p1 is equal to h1 rho g, and the downward thrust on the upper surface is f1, that is f force is equal to pressure into area, so f1 is equal to p1 into a. Here p1 is equal to h1 rho g, so we can write f1 means that is force thrust applied on the upper surface, that is h1 rho g into a. The pressure on the lower surface of the body on this surface, that is p2 is equal to h2 rho g. The pressure are exerted in these directions, and the upward thrust on the lower surface f2 is equal to, we know that force is equal to pressure into area, so force f2 is equal to, here force is f2 and pressure is p2 and the area of the base is a, so here p2 is equal to h2 rho g, so we put the h2 rho g in place of p2, so it becomes h2 rho g into a. And the horizontal thrust acting on the vertical sides of the body, being equal and opposite for all the sides, cancel out, means the thrust applied on the vertical side on these sides and these sides are in opposite directions, so these thrust cancels each others. Net of thrust is F, that is F2 minus F1. The value of F2 is H2 rho Ga and the value of F1 is H1 rho Ga. So if we take common rho Ga, then it becomes H2 minus H1 rho Ga. Here the volume of body is H2 minus H1. Height into area is called volume. So the volume of the body is H2 minus H1, that is H into A. Here buoyant force, yani net of thrust force, it becomes, if we put H2 minus H1, A is V, then it becomes buoyant force is equal to, means up thrust is equal to V rho G. Here V rho means mass of the body and G acceleration due to gravity. So up thrust is equal to that is weight of the body. So up thrust is equal to weight of the displaced liquids. So in this way, we prove the Archimedes principle. Now let us discuss the next topic, density. What is density? Mass per unit volume is called density. Means density is equal to mass by volume. Density is denoted by rho. That is rho. Means if the symbol of density is rho and the symbol of mass is m and symbol of volume is v, then rho is equal to m by v. The SI unit of density is, the unit of mass is kg and the unit of volume is meter cube. So the SI unit of density is kg per meter cube. And in CGS system, the unit of density is gram per centimeter cube. Now we will study the next topic, what is relative density. Relative density means density of substance with respect to, with the ratio of the density of the substance to the density of water at 4 degrees Celsius is known as relative density of the substance. Means relative density is equal to density of substance by density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. Since the relative density is comprehension of the same physical quantity, so it has no units. Use of Archimedes principles to obtain relative density. Relative density for solids and liquids can also be determined with the help of Archimedes principles.
Here we know that the relative density is equal to weight of the solid body in air by loss in the weight of the body in water. Here W1 is the weight of the body in air and W2 is the weight of the body in water. So W1 minus W2 is the loss of the weight in the water. So relative density is equal to weight of the body in air by loss of the weight of body in water. Now this is the relative density of solids obtained by with the help of Archimedes principles. Then now obtained the relative density for liquids with the help of Archimedes principle. Here relative density is equal to loss of the weight in liquid by loss of the weight in water, means here W minus W1 W double dash by W minus W dash. What is W? W means weight of the body in air. W dash means weight of the body when it is fully immersed in water. W double dash means weight of the body when fully immersed in liquids. Then loss of the weight of the weight in liquid is equal to W minus W double dash, and loss of the weight in water is equal to W minus W dash. So this is the relative density of liquid determined with the help of Archimedes principle. Study the use of Archimedes principle. Where we use Archimedes principle? Archimedes principle is used in ship and submarines, and it is also used in hydrometer, which is used for finding the density of liquids. And the Archimedes principle is also used in lactometer, which is used to test the purity of the milk. So these are the some uses of Archimedes principle.